What's up, guys? We're back on Westbridge. We just finished up mowing. I was waiting to finish up a little project I was working on, which is the Frontier WR5417 rake. So this is kind of a nice little alternative to my Oxbow merger. It's a little bit more affordable. If you look in the store, it is 29,000 as compared to, 92,000 for the merger. That being said, this setup can only do a maximum of technically 8.8 meters, but I have it set for 9 meters just to make it easy. It can only do 9 meter swaths, windrows, where the Oxbow merger can merge, make 22 meter swaths. So it's smaller, but it's also cheaper. It's definitely a unique little piece of equipment. I rather enjoyed making it and studying it and stuff like that. It's got walking tandems, interesting way of unfolding and way it raises and lowers the rakes. In real life, you have the ability to actually adjust each wing. I don't have it set up like that right now. Right now, it just has a single fold-unfold function. So if we come outside the cab, you'll be able to see cylinders pushing out the center, and then the cylinders on the side here hold the wing, and then this other cylinder kind of pushes this pole, which releases the springs and chains, lowers the actual rakes. So that's cool. So I have my line set up for 9 meters. It's got blinkers, brake lights, running lights, which we'll probably turn on. It's getting close to sundown. Along and it just merges. Might have to adjust some particles, but go ahead and close our door for a more quiet cab. But that's all it does. It's just kind of a more American rake. I haven't really seen anything like this built before, so it's nice to be at the forefront of that. But it's definitely a very cool piece of equipment. Works well. Nice to have a piece of Frontier equipment to So these are, this is built to scale. I believe the brake wheels are like 1.5 meters or somewhere is about there. I forget the actual number, but all built to scale. Looks really good behind that 6R. This rake is all manually UV mapped as well. What I mean by that is it's all manually seamed, mark seams to unwrap. And I did that on this and that baler and this 6R. First three mods that are all completely manually UV mapped, and you know, it really doesn't take that much effort as you're building it. You just kind of like mark the seams as you go and check how everything unwraps. And when you're done with your build, it's already done. So as you do it as you're building, it makes it pretty easy to manage. And obviously, once you like keep doing it enough, you kind of can visualize how you want things to get cut, kind of lay out textures. But yeah, I haven't really paid much attention to rakes, and then once I finish the game. Became interested in doing some more Forge and Paint. And the merger is, I mean, as great and as efficient as it is, how much ground you can cover with it. It's very expensive. I feel like a small to medium size dairy farmer really wouldn't be able to afford something like that. So this kind of fills a void that in-game equipment, in-game, this is the same size as that Pottinger. It's the same size as this one. 32,000, that's 12.5, okay. So, a little bit smaller than that, but when I had it in GE, it was exactly the same working with, so I think they might be fudging the numbers on that working with. This is kind of that, in that same class. Same price point. That merger though, when you compare it to the in-game rank, that in-game crown just completely destroys it with value. It's you look at this thing, it's 75,000, does 19 meters. Oxbow converged 22 meters, do it a lot quicker. Plus, get access to the conditioner, conditions, turns that hay over. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with how well this turned out. I was kind of scratching my head how I was going to strip raise and lower, and ended up just making the chains moving parts. I was considering doing like separate components. I had the walking tandems as separate components, but they would like slide around, so just made it one. Actually really cool. It's really fun to use, to be honest. There's a whole lot going on. It's fun for the eyes. Keeps your eyes entertained, I guess. Simple design, all things considered, mechanically. The raise and lower mechanism, very straightforward, very simple. The actual one in real life is a little bit more complex, has a little bit more going on with springs and stuff like that. For the game purposes, it's kept a little simple. Thank you. everything is like ratchet styled cranks to adjust pitches and angles. Oh, and then I also made it have a, you can, depending on what kind of tractor you're using with it, you can adjust the hitch to make sure it's nice and level. Try to add some usable functions to it. Support rotates out of the way. And so now I'm just kind of curious how many people are gonna like have Polygonish make one of these. I give it a week. Until he starts getting flooded with requests. Next thing I have to do is make some bale forks and probably some pallet forks as well. Probably make square bale and round bale forks. And then after that, I'm not really sure. Solid equipment after that. The hay production. Looking at this, you can see even the spikes are pretty well detailed, or the rakes, whatever you want to call them. Yeah, that was nice. Made it nice and easy. Just drive this back, grab our baler. There's something about making hay that's just fun. I mean, everything about it, besides collecting it, is it just mowing it, windrowing, baling it. $6,175, it's a pretty solid tractor. I mean, in these steeper hills, it barely has enough power to get up with the baler, but overall, it's pretty good. Climbing hills with it, though, with the front loader and bales, it's definitely, you can feel it underpowered compared to the 6215. Obviously, heavy duty tillage and planting. probably pull a grand car with it if you wanted to. It's like an 850,000 bushels per RPM. Pull a leg, that's for sure. Anyways, I think our little hay crop is doing very well. Yield wise, we're getting quite a few bales out of it. See if I can model up a bale fork or two tomorrow and get those in game. Test them out on these bales. Might make a smaller, my 26-23, I might make a smaller disc, something I could pull with a 6R. Disking with it. males out of this little field. That's not too bad. 6,000 liters in every male. Anyways, guys.